And we're back, and we are really fortunate to have with us a student. That's right, a student at Rogers State, and the young man's name is Cole Chandler. Cole, welcome, lad.
It's good to be here. Thank you so much.
And the reason you're here is because you have done a home run video that we're fixing to share with folks who are viewing with us this afternoon. Was this a class assignment?
Yeah, this was an assignment for my advanced broadcast practicum class by Lee Williams.
Are you a broadcast major?
Yes, sir. My third year in it. So,
what do you plan to do with it?
I'm planning to work at a studio in Tulsa right now. So either be a studio mate or just be the main assistant for a while.
Well, this video you put together is all your idea. You edited as well, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
All right. Let's, is there a name for it?
It's called Isolation. So,
let's take a break, folks, and give your attention to Cole's class project called Isolation.
I wake up. It's 6 a.m. and the sun is already beginning to rise. I peek from the warmth of my blanket through the cracks of my blinds and see the deep blue begin to mix with an ultraviolet. I wake up. It's 8:06 and the sun has already welcomed itself into my room. I am not as welcoming. I get up and I get ready. I'm not seeing anyone today, so I'm dressing solely for the purpose of comfort. I sit at my desk and log into my college. The classrooms are now replaced with my room, and my friends are downscaled to a 133 by 133 pixel image on my computer screen. My day's assignments start to come into view. My professor's lectures and speeches are now reduced to black and white, unmotivating and uninspiring. I start my assignment in my first class. I finish and move on to the second, and then my third. I get bored of my big computer screen and choose my smaller one. I check in with my friends on Instagram to see if they have posted anything new or really exciting. And I scroll, and I scroll, and scroll. By the time I'm done with it all, I start to feel hungry. It's only 1 p.m. It's only 1 p.m. I reheat something that my mom packed for me last night when I went to her house. I think to myself, what else can I do today? I've been as productive as I can be. Maybe I can watch a movie, or I can play a game, read a book, but I can't go out. Going out would mean that I have the chance to be infected, or even worse, take the chance of getting others infected. But I shouldn't complain, because I am not the only one in the exact same scenario. Everyone isn't going outside. Everyone is staying home. But I miss getting in my car with my friends, the music loud and the conversations electrifying. I miss sitting down with people, eating and drinking and laughing, sharing the entire experience together. And all of that was taken away. And I miss it. Has taken over the nation, and now we all grow fearful of each other. And even at the smallest sign of ill health, we grow fearful of ourselves. I never thought that being in a history-shaping moment just like this, having affected all 7 billion people, that it would feel so lonely. But if it had to be at any time, why should it have not been now? If we look back at our history and compare, we are the most well-equipped to deal with such a virus at such a massive scale. Our medicine is at its peak. Our research is cutting edge. Our medical staff is the most educated it's ever been. And even though we don't have a cure today, who knows if we won't have a cure tomorrow? Even in the most lonely virus, we have all remained so connected. The amount of tools at our disposal to stay connected is so vast and varied. Friends can still check on their friends. Even though I can't do anything more than talk with someone, doesn't mean I still can't go see them. I can still send inspiring things to my friends through my group chat. I can still call my mom and tell her how thankful I am for her and how much I love her. I can call my friends and jam out with them, trying to get the timing just right as the call goes in and out of sync. I can FaceTime my brother and skateboard with him while we are miles and miles away in completely different parts of the state. Even in the most depressing virus that has hit the modern age, we can still find new ways to hope. Even though we aren't all living life together, it doesn't mean that we all still can't live life together.
Are we done?
Yeah, we're done.
All right.
Love you. Love you too.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
And that's a wrap, Cole. Who was your photographer?
Me. I shot and produced everything.
Even the stuff where you're... It's action stuff? Would you use a selfie stick?
No, I mean, I just held my camera. I mean, all footage was shot by me. Some of the footage, like the doctor and some of my friends, that was shot on different days for different projects, and so I combined them into this video.
You know what? I think you're going to do well in the business. I really do. That's an excellent piece, because what you've done is you have captured the isolation mood that settled in over many hundreds of thousands, if not millions of people in this country because of the pandemic. And I don't know if that was intentional or not, but you did it. And you're being
thank you so much. Thank you.
When do you get a grade on it?
I got a grade. I got a full A. So, I mean, that's
sweet.
It's really good.
So we got that out of the way. What's next on the drawing board for you?
What's next is probably my next year of schooling. And again, trying to work my way into that studio and really show them what I'm capable of and show them that I've earned a place there.
Are you wanting to be on camera or are you wanting to be a shooter?
Really, when I first got into this, I wanted to be in front of the camera. I wanted to be like a news anchor. But the more I got into what goes on behind the scenes, I really started enjoying that more. And I started becoming a little bit of a perfectionist on it. So I love being behind the camera now.
Well, let me share a couple of things with you that really class A photographers I've known over the years have shared with me. As you go through life with a camera in your hand, look for those things that other photographers don't pay any attention to. Look for the hands. See what the hands are doing of the person you're interviewing. Watch their habits. Watch their mannerisms. Because you're going to learn a lot just from those three areas. Now pack that away in your suitcase, lad. Have you got stories in your happy bag that you want to shoot?
I would say my whole life is pretty happy. I mean, I'm surrounded by very optimistic and inspiring people. And so all of the people I get to come in contact with and who help grow me and push me, I want to capture their stories, really.
Well, where are you from? We didn't get to that even. Where is home for you?
Here, Claremore, Oklahoma, born and raised.
No kidding.
Mm-hmm.
Brothers and sisters?
Yep, my brother in the video, his name is Scout, and he's 9 years old, so super cool. Coolest kid I know.
Any sisters?
Nope, just the one, just me and him.
Well, if anybody tells you that you have to move to a larger market to make it, take that with a grain of salt. Get the experience where you can, and then make your decisions on going around. And I will tell you something else. There are two books I want to recommend to you. One is, they call it, put out by, I think AP printed it, but it's put out by the University of Oklahoma Press, and it's how every town, village, and hamlet in the state got its name. We'll do you some good someday.
All right, I'll read it.
The second is Aviation Weather. You never know, man, when you're going to be a spotter or be pressed into service as a spotter, and you'll need to know a little bit about what you're talking about, and it's a basic handbook on weather conditions, what everything means, how it all acts. Other than that, you just got to get some experience.
Yeah, definitely. For sure.
Are you
checking out?
A little bit put off by the graduation element?
Am I put off by it? I don't think I'm put off by it.
I mean, no line. You can't go through a formal graduation.
Well, I won't be graduating yet. This is only my third year. So.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was under the impression you were a senior, for goodness sake.
No, I mean, I'm finishing up my junior year. So.
Okay, well, then when you do your senior project, you got to bring it in, okay?
I will definitely, for sure.
I have a sneaky feeling it's going to be a really, really good one.
I was just talking with my professor about that today, Lee Williams. So, what my capstone's going to be. So, be on the lookout.
All right. Good to roll them up. Well, listen, Cole, I want to thank you for coming by. And just in passing, what made you choose Rogers State?
I love the small campus environment. I mean, this is where I grew up. And so, I wouldn't have gotten as good of a relationship with the communications department, such as Andrew Nichols, Lee Williams, Steve Drywater. They really have inspired me and pushed me to be more. And I would have not have had that through a large scale university. So this is perfect. This is home.
Well, if you get a chance, go by and talk to Royal Ailes or any of the guys in our TV department. I'm sure they'd be glad to talk with you about your video and your future plans. A lot of experience
awesome.
Upstairs. Hey, Cole, thanks for being a part of it, and we'll see you next time around.
Thank you, Sam. Have a good day.
Bye. Well, that's all the time we have for this edition of Perspectives. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us. And before I close it out, I just want to remind you, wear your mask if you're going to be out there. For now, thanks for joining us. Good night and good luck.